miracle is, that's the feeling of a real miracle. Would you please take 30 seconds and just lift up that neighbor before God in the name of Jesus. We bless you, we honor you, we give you praise, we adore you. You're a mighty God. You deserve all praise, you deserve all honor, you deserve all power, Jehovah God. There is indeed no one like you. No one can be able to compare to your doings. No one can be able to compare to your workings, oh God. Thank you for the dear ones that, Lord, are represented in this house tonight. It's our prayer that may you touch them, may you elevate them, may you encourage them, may you heal them, may you deliver them. I pray that, Lord, they shall, King of Glory God, feel rejuvenated today to the glory and honor of your name. We bless you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody just give the Lord a mighty hand clap and give him a shout. Let's give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah. You may have your wonderful seats if you can. Thank you very much. This is our year of divine elevation. I believe all of us are aware. This is our year of divine elevation. And I believe all those that have come to this service today, it's not an accident. God is indeed going to elevate you to the glory and honor of his name. Praise the name of Jesus. I just want to speak to you on something different. In the first service, I was talking about the demand for salty saints. And I felt in my spirit as I was praying, just to be able to share with you on the God of open doors, doors of divine elevation. I'll be making several declarations in this place, and I believe that God is indeed going to open doors for your lives in the name of Jesus. If you really do believe it, say amen. I'm in the book of Revelation, chapter number 3. Revelation, chapter number 3. I'm reading from the New King James Version. Revelation, chapter number 3, from verse 7 all the way through to 8. The Bible says, "And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things says he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens. I know your works. See, I have set before you an open door, and no one can shut it. For you have a little strength, but have kept my word and have not denied my name." I want us to go a little bit down in the same chapter in verse number 19 and 20. Verse 19 and 20. The Bible says, "Those whom I love, I rebuke and discipline. So be honest and repent. Here I am, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with that person and they with me." I want you to understand that in this chapter, God is talking about two particular doors. He's talking to the church of Philadelphia that kept his word, and he's saying he has set an open door. And he speaks to the church of Laodicea and he says, "If you hear me knocking at the door of your heart." So I want you to understand that there are doors that you open yourselves, and there are doors that God opens himself. Are we understanding one another? He says, "I have set before you an open door. The doors that I open, no man can shut." On the other side, it's simply saying, "Behold, I stand at the door of your heart and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and eat with him." Praise the name of Jesus. I want you to all understand, I'm just doing a foundation so that I can be able to preach. The Bible, it says very clearly, just in a definition, that a door represents either access or denial, depending on whether it is opened or it is closed. And the mystery of doors figure heavily in the scripture. It talks about doors symbolically and some literally about 263 times mentioning the name doors. And so when we read the verses 7 to 8, it makes it crystal clear that the person who is opening this particular door in verse 7 to 8 is none other but Jesus Christ. And I want us all to be able to understand very clearly that before God opens a door to anyone, he always introduces himself. He makes it clear, who am I to you, for him to be able to open the door. He introduced himself to Abraham when he was at the age of 90 years in Genesis chapter number 17 verse 1 and 2. And he introduced himself as the Lord God Almighty. He was telling Abraham, I want you to know, as long as you've got a relationship with me, I am a mighty God. I'm all powerful. I can do what no man can be able to do. Everything that I declare in your life comes to pass. Therefore, when I declare, I will bless those that bless you and curse those that curse you and make you great, I do so not because I'm a man, but I'm doing so because I am the Almighty God, and besides me there is no other. He introduces himself also, and he introduces himself to Moses and introduces himself as Jehovah. I am the only God. I'm the all-sufficient God. I am the one in charge of your life. That's according to Exodus chapter number 6 verse 1 to 3. But he doesn't stop there also. He also introduces himself as the God of Abraham, as the God of Isaac, telling us very clearly that I want you to know I'm the God of all generations. If I was able to bless your daddy, I'm able to bless your son, and I'm able to bless everything that comes out of your loins, as long as you're totally connected to me as Jehovah in your life. He doesn't stop there, but he introduces himself to various people in scripture as Jehovah Nissi, the Lord my banner, as Jehovah Ebenezer, this far the Lord has brought us, as Jehovah Elohim. He introduces himself as Jehovah Rofeka, the Lord our healer. He introduces himself as Jehovah Rohi, the Lord our shepherd, simply because we serve a God who desires to open doors for each and every person. Can I hear somebody say an amen? I want us also to understand that the Lord cares for us so much to open doors in our lives. And every person who is in this place, it was not a mistake for us to be able to declare this year that this is a year of divine elevation. If it is a year of divine elevation, then there are divine doors that God opens for you to be able to be elevated and to be lifted at another level to the glory and honor of his name. Since we declare it's the year of divine elevation in the order of Joseph, I want us also to look at a scripture that will show the door that God opened for Joseph. And since it's the year of divine elevation in the order of Joseph, I shall declare several doors over your life. And I believe by the end of this service, there are certain doors that will be opened over your lives. I don't say this because preachers say it, but I say it because I'm convicted in my spirit. And I know under the anointing that is in this house, there are miracles that will sprout up in this place because we are serving the God of open doors. Can I hear somebody say an amen? I feel the spirit of a preaching coming over me. Genesis chapter number 41, verse 41 all the way through to 44. I'm sorry for the screens. I believe you guys managed to carry their Bibles by the grace of God and your tablets and your iPhones. You can please turn to Genesis chapter number 41, verse 41 to 44. And the Bible says, and Pharaoh said to Joseph, see, I have set over all the land of Egypt. I have set you over all the land of Egypt. Then Pharaoh took his signet ring from his hand and put it on Joseph's hand and clothed him in garments of fine linen and put a golden chain about his neck. And he made him ride in his second chariot. And they called out before him, bow the knee. Thus he set him over all the land of Egypt. I believe by now you know the story of Joseph. Joseph, how he was able to be thrown into the pit and sold as a slave and ended up in the palace and again thrown into the prison, and God took him out of prison and put him in a place of authority. That was God opening doors. I want you, as children of God, when we talk about the God of doors, we should always appreciate God for opening doors and shutting certain doors. And every time he opens or shuts a door, it is simply because he cares for each and every one of you. Because there are some of us, if the Lord God Almighty opens a door early, he knows when he opens it early, you might not necessarily be able to handle the blessing that he will release over your life. And so there are times he shuts a door that you may be able to mature in the spirit. And the moment you are able to receive a particular thing, then he opens a door. So please do not complain when a door has been shut for a moment. If you read in the scriptures, there are several times that God shut different doors, but God still meant it for good by the end of the day. There are those who desire to get babies but could not be able to get babies until they were done with the way God was dealing with the dealings of the Lord. And when they were ready, God opened their wombs and they were able to birth out prophets by the end of the day, because they were ready for the open doors. So the God that we are talking about is a God who always has an expression of love whenever he wants to open a door for us. He releases activities in our lives that will propel us to reach to the zenith of our lives in order for us to be able to embrace divine elevation. Can I hear somebody say an amen? Can I hear somebody say an amen? Please allow me to preach right now so that I can be able to declare certain doors over your life. Because if God opened a door for Joseph, you are not an exception. He can also be able to open a door for you in the name of Jesus. Can I hear the amens of Deliverance Church Umoja? When you read your Bibles in the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 16, verse 8 to 9, according to the NIV version, the Bible says, "But I will stay on at Ephesus until Pentecost, because a great door for effective work has opened to me, and there are many who oppose me." I want you to understand, when the Bible talks of a great and effective door, when it brings in the word great, it talks about the magnitude of what God wants to do in your life. It cannot be measured by men when God wants to open that door. I also want you to understand that when he talks about an effective door, he's speaking of a door that is supposed to be active. It's a fixed door. It's a powerful door. And the door that I'm talking about here is the door of opportunity. Joseph was given an opportunity to be a governor. And when he was given that opportunity, he seized the moment and ran with it. There is a Chinese proverb that says, "Teachers open the doors, but you must enter by yourself." Because God opens doors of opportunities for us, but he will never force you to enter through that door. It is upon you as an individual to take a step of faith and get in. And that's why Revelation told us, "Behold, I have set an open door before you." I've come to declare over your lives today, there is a door of opportunity that has been opened for each and every one of us. And it is expected of us as children of God in this year of divine elevation to enter in. I declare in the name of Jesus, may the Lord God open a door of opportunity, an opportunity to travel, an opportunity to do business, an opportunity to marry and to be married, an opportunity to own property, an opportunity to tender and to receive the tender, an opportunity to love and to be loved, an opportunity to be promoted, to be taken into the next level, an opportunity for a new job, an opportunity for a new career, may the same God that opened up a door for Joseph and took him through the vicissitudes of life but placed him at a place of authority, may the same God give you an opportunity this year as a child of God to be able to do things that people thought you could not be able to do. May the God that we serve this year enable you as a child of God to be able to handle more money than your parents could be able to handle. May the God of opportunities open a door for you that the baby you thought you could never birth, may the Lord give you signs of pregnancy that you may be able to hold and handle your own. In the name of Jesus, I declare doors of opportunities. I declare doors of opportunities. I declare doors of opportunities in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you ready to listen to me? Door number two. It is the door of utterance. The door of utterance. This is an opportunity for you to speak. Because that which you speak matters. What you say can either build or break anybody. I want you to know, the Bible says very clearly in Colossians chapter number 4 and verse number 3. Meanwhile, praying also for us that God would open to us a door for the word to speak the mystery of Christ, for which I am also in chains, that I may make it manifest as I ought to speak. The Bible says in Proverbs 18:21, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruits. It is expected of us as children of God to always speak things that are positive. When Joseph interpreted the dream, when he opened his mouth to speak, the Bible says very clearly, and what Joseph said pleased everybody. Those that were born again and those that were not born again, it pleased everybody. I've come to tell you, child of God, whatever you utter matters, because there are words that you say that can break somebody. There are times we use degradation terms to define people when we are given an opportunity to speak. Our speeches are not seasoned with salt. We crush down people, yet we want to be elevated. You talk down your husband and you want to be elevated. You talk down your boss and you want to be elevated. In this year, God is opening a door of utterance, and he says those that love it will eat their fruit. And I want you as children of God to always be able to speak positive things in your lives. Speak a healthy marriage in your life. Speak wealth in your life. Speak a breakthrough in your life. Speak a new dimension in your life. Speak a new horizon in your life. It is what you say. If you want people to appreciate you, keep on speaking positive things. The Bible says in the book of Colossians chapter number 4 that your speech should always be seasoned with salt. It should be pleasant and interesting to hear. When you open your mouth, what do people hear? What do people say? Because when Joseph opened his mouth, it was pleasing and interesting to hear. I pray this year that the Lord shall give you the grace to be able to speak positive things in the lives of the people that you'll come into contact with, and especially those that are close to you and those that are related to you. Do not abuse them, but bless them. Do not misuse them, but bless them. Talk good about people. And I guarantee you, if you speak properly concerning people and situations, the Lord shall change the atmosphere. We cannot stand on this pulpit and always pray that may the God of heaven grant us peace in this nation. But when you're seated alone, you speak negativity concerning this nation. God is giving you an opportunity again to be able to speak things that are positive in this nation. You better open up your mouth and say the nation of Kenya shall not go to the dogs. The economy of Kenya shall not dwindle and go under. But as a child of God who is anointed by the Father, who is expecting divine elevation, God is opening a door of utterance that every single moment you get an opportunity, you may talk to Jehovah concerning this nation, concerning your family, concerning your business, concerning your place of employment. It's your opportunity to open up your mouth. Listen to me, child of God. Romans chapter 8 verse 9 says, and the word of God is near you, even unto your mouth. If you confess, God is expecting that if you know it's the year of divine elevation, be your own prophet. Prophesy to yourself. Encourage yourself. Declare you shall not go under, but you shall stand. You've got to declare, my Father. Every year there have been declarations. They've always remained as declarations, as themes of the year. But you must make up your mind this year. The year of divine elevation shall not just be a theme, but you shall be part and parcel of this year in the name of Jesus. Walk like an elevated person. Talk like an elevated person. Behave like an elevated person. It's your ear of utterance. You talk to yourself. You talk to yourself. The Bible says very clearly that even the woman with the issue of blood, with all that she went through, the Bible says she talked to herself. If only I can touch but the hem of the garment of Jesus. I know things are bad in my life, but I'm talking to myself. If only I can touch. I know I'm in the pit, but my destiny is not in the pit. If only I can touch. I know I'm in the prison, but I'm not confined for the rest of my life. If only I can speak freedom in my life. God is giving you an opportunity to be able to speak. When you lay your hands on your children, speak divine elevation, speak divine influence, speak a positive influence. Declare you shall not die before your age. Declare you shall not be the tail but the hair. Declare you shall be a source of joy at every single moment. It's an opportunity for you to speak. Give your neighbor a high five and tell them, speak, 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 speak. In the name of Jesus. Listen to me, child of God. When God is giving you an opportunity to utter something, there is something that is so important in a scripture that we always read. Matthew chapter number 16 and verse number 19. In the New Living Translation, it says, and I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you forbid on earth will be forbidden in heaven. Whatever you permit on earth will be permitted in heaven. The Bible is simply saying, everything you say with your mouth, heaven will back it up. If you confess you are lazy, heaven will back it up. If you say I must be elevated, heaven will back it up. If you declare my business is not going down, heaven will back it up. For whatever you forbid here on earth, no sickness in my family, no divorce in my family, no losses in my business, I shall not backslide, I shall not compromise. Heaven will back it up, and God will send his angels, and they'll keep on saying, did you hear what my son said? He ain't going under. He's standing on the word. He's standing on the promises. I declare in the name of Jesus, may every opportunity given to you to speak, speak positively.
speak life, speak the truth, speak elevation, speak determination in the name of Jesus. Somebody give the Lord a mighty hand clap in the name of the Lord God Almighty. Are you ready for another door? Are you ready for another door? I want to declare this. And for everybody that knows you have a situation in your life, when I'm declaring this, I want you to stand and begin to receive it in the name of Jesus. Because I feel in my spirit, there is a spirit of freedom. Freedom that's gonna move in this place as I declare this today. These are the doors of freedom. Acts chapter number 16 and verse number 26. The Bible says, and suddenly there was a great earthquake so that the foundations of the prisons were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's bonds was unfastened. You never heard that word again. Let me read it again. And suddenly, it's going to be an immediate, within a twinkling of an eye. And suddenly, there was a great earthquake so that the foundations of the prisons, the foundations of what was holding you was shaken. And immediately, somebody say immediately. And immediately, all the doors swung open and everyone's bonds were fastened. Martin Luther King Jr. says, freedom is never voluntarily given by the oppressor. It must be demanded by the oppressed. I'm going to say it again. He says, freedom is never voluntarily given by the oppressor. It must be demanded by the oppressed. And I want to declare today that the same way the Lord sent an earthquake and it shook the foundations. I want to speak to foundations now. And it shook the foundations because the doors were swung open and the foundations were shaken. I declare today, in the name of Jesus, may the Lord minister to you freedom. Freedom from poverty, in the name of Jesus. Freedom from financial debts, in the name of Jesus. Freedom from sinful habits, sinful behaviors, laziness and procrastination. May the Lord free you today from greed. May the Lord declare freedom over you. Freedom over sexual immorality. Freedom over pornography. Freedom over unfaithfulness. Freedom over promiscuity. Freedom over adultery. Freedom over lies. Freedom over bitterness. Freedom over unforgiveness. Freedom over anger. Freedom over alcoholism. Freedom over drugs. As the foundations were shaken, I release an earthquake. I release an earthquake. May it shake every foundation. Oh, I hear a rumbling in the spirit. Foundations are being shaken. Foundations are being shaken. And I declare in the name of Jesus, the year of divine elevation shall be our portion. Nothing shall hinder us. Nothing shall stop us. Nothing shall impede our movement. Nothing shall be an encumbrance to our next level. I declare freedom. Laziness, you are not my portion. When I look at myself, God created me for greatness. Poverty, you shall not master me. He was made poor at the cross that I may be rich. You shall not master me. I declare in the name of Jesus, I shall not be a slave to debt. Shylocks, I'm running you out of business. You shall not be a hindrance to me. Loans, I'm rendering you out of business. Because I must be delivered. I must receive freedom. I must go to the next level. There is a door of freedom. A door of freedom. A door of freedom. Somebody receive it. Somebody catch it. Somebody embrace it. Somebody run after it. There is a door. Somebody give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. He is the God of open doors. You can have your seats if you can. It's not only the doors of freedom, but it's also the doors of hope. The doors of hope. The Bible says in the book of Hosea, chapter number 2 and verse number 15, it says, I will give her vineyards from there and the valley of Achor as a door of hope. She shall sing there as in the days of her youth, as in the day when she came up from the land of Egypt. You know, this is the story of Hosea and his wife Gomer, who went back to prostitution. And Hosea was wondering, will I be able to redeem my wife back? Will I be able to buy my wife back? But God said unto him, I will give her vineyards from there and the valley of Achor. The word Achor in Hebrew simply means trouble. So he says, I will give her vineyards from there and the valley of trouble as a door of hope. All right. Did you know God will always create a situation for a revelation? Oftentimes when God wants to reveal himself, he will always create a situation. And some of the situations that he creates are not things that are palatable to us. So Joseph saw a dream. He saw things bowing before him. He knew elevation was coming. But between him and his dream, he never saw the pits. He never saw the trouble. He never saw himself at Potiphar's house. He never saw himself in prison. If anybody ever lied to you that when you get saved, it is an insurance cover against trouble, they lied to you. All right, these people are annoyed. Let me talk to these ones here. Jesus declared in John chapter number 16 and verse 33, he declared very clearly that in this world, where? In this world, not the world to come. In this world, you shall have trouble. But be of good cheer, because I have overcome the world. And today I know there are men and women that are seated in this place, that if it were not for God on your side, you would have given up. By the fact that you landed in this church today, it was a miracle by itself. And I've come to declare to you, it is not a mistake for you to come here. God is opening a door of hope. There is a door of hope that all the things that seem dead, you thought they would not rise again. We are releasing resurrection. We are releasing resurrection. That business is not going under. Some of you began to advertise that there is an open space. Anyone who wants to do business and you are shutting down your business, the devil is a liar. You are a child of God. You are created for greatness and you shall not go under. I release the door of hope over your life. I release the door of hope over your life. I release the door of hope over your life. I feel like declaring today, your marriage shall not be unglued. Your children shall not be wayward for the rest of their lives. I feel like declaring today, there are some that have been praying for their children. They've been in drug abuse and they've been wondering, when will God ever restore my son? I've come to declare to you today, in this year of divine elevation, there is an open door for hope. God shall restore your joy. God shall restore your happiness. There is a peace that surpasses all human understanding that God is about to release over every person that felt like you will never make it in life. I declare in the name of Jesus, elevation shall not be elusive. Elevation shall not be elusive. You might have begun on a bad note. You began on a bad note. But I declare to you, you can make it. You can make it. You can make it. Listen to me, child of God. There's a man by the name Henry Ford. He said, whether you think you can or you can't, you are right. If you think there's a door of hope, you are right. If you think you cannot get into a door of hope, you are also right. But Deliverance Church Umoja shall not go under. Shall not go under. For there is a door of hope. I love reading. And so there is a man by the name William Faulkner who said, you cannot swim for new horizons until you have the courage to lose sight of the shore. I'll say it again so that we can be able to receive it. He says, you cannot swim for new horizons until you have courage to lose sight of the shore. Tell your neighbor, let the dead bury their dead. It was over. I'm not going back to it. I shall not hang on it. It happened. It shall not eat me up. It shall not get into my mind. It shall not cause me to be incompetent at work. I must work. I must move forward. I'm losing sight of the show. For I'm seeing divine elevation. I'm seeing myself moving higher. I'm seeing myself into a new level. And I cannot get into the new level if I'm still holding on to my past. Oh, if you got me out of your life via SMS, that's okay. You better go and find someone else. But my hope is being revived. I'm hoping again. Just as Abraham hoped against hope, we are also hoping against hope. It might look like it's not okay. But on the other side, I'm seeing myself clearly. Seeing myself driving my own car. I'm seeing myself clearly, walking down the aisle, coming to tie a note. I'm seeing myself clearly, walking in a shapeless manner. They thought I could not have a baby, but now look at what the Lord has done. I know I was retrenched and I thought I could not make it, but there's a door of hope. You can be able to work again. You can be able to earn again. You shall not beg. You shall not borrow. But the Lord shall make sure that your barns will never run dry. The Lord shall make sure that blessed shall you be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country. There is a door of hope that is being released over this house tonight. I may not continue with my message, but I feel a need to declare there is a door of hope. There are those you thought that would never get saved, but there's a door of hope. We are calling them for Jesus. We are calling them to salvation. There is a door of hope that is being released this morning. May the God that opened doors, may the God that opened doors open a door of hope for you right now. In the name of Jesus. Shake your neighbor's hand like you're going to shake it off and tell them, neighbor, I'm hoping again. I'm hoping again. I'm hoping again. Somebody give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Listen to me, child of God. There's a woman by the name Barbara Kingsolver who said, the very least you can do in your life is figure out what you hope for. And the most you can do is live inside that hope. Not admire it from a distance, but live right in it, under his roof. So I'm telling you, children of God, the very least you can do in your life in this year of divine elevation, figure out how to hope again. Figure out how to hope again. If daddy has opened that door, nobody can shut it. No witchcraft power can shut it. No dust thrower can shut it. No soothsayer can shut it. No mother-in-law can shut it. When God opens a door, nobody can be able to shut it. Listen to me, child of God. And he says very clearly that the reason as to why I have set an open door before you is because you kept my word. You held on to my word. You never forsook my name. You never stopped coming to church. You never stopped praying and fasting. You never stopped reading on the word of God. You hoped against hope. Lord, what are you saying concerning my life? And you read your word. May the door of hope be opened unto you. I want to say the last thing here. You may have your seats for a few seconds. I'm about to finish in the name of the Lord. I'm about to finish in the name of the Lord. There is a door of answered prayers. Matthew chapter number 7, verse number 7 to 11. It says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. He continues with verse 9 and he says, which of you, if your son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a snake? If you, then though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your father in heaven, divine connection, connecting to deity, relationship, how much more will your father, if he's your father, you're a son, if he's your father, you're a daughter, how do you become a son? All those that received him, he gave them the power to become children of God. How much more will your father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him? And I decree today that the prayers you have been praying, they never went to waste. The Lord has always been inclining his ear towards your prayer. It is coming to him like a sweet smelling fragrance. At times he tells the angels, I want you to shut up because my son is talking. My daughter is talking. And I believe today the prayers you have been making. These people are not ready. The prayers you have been making shall be answered. A Nigerian preacher said, it must be answered by fire and by thunder. Whichever means, the Lord must answer. In the name of the Lord God Almighty. For he says in his word, the promises of God are yes and amen. And everything we ask of the Father, we shall receive. We serve a God who has a habit of answering our prayers. And I pray that in this church, the Lord shall answer your prayer. The Lord shall answer your prayer. To an extent, divine elevation shall not come at the end of the year. But it shall begin to swim in elevation this month, in the name of Jesus. This month, in the name of, shall we all rise up in the name of the Lord God Almighty and begin to tell God, God, open doors. Open doors in my life. Open doors in my life. Doors of salvation. Doors of protection. doors of divine help, doors of answered prayers, doors of hope. Tell God to open doors. There's an atmosphere right now of doors being opened all over this area. There are some of you that will walk out of this door when God has totally healed you, because doors of divine health are being released in the name of Jesus. I cast every tumor. I command it to dry up. I command it to dry up in the name of Jesus. I rebuke every foul disease that has come into your life. I command it to go away in the name of Jesus. I release the door of divine health. I release the door of divine health in Jesus' name. Somebody give the Lord a mighty hand clap in the house. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Yes. Give him a praise. He is the God of open doors. Give at least 5 people a high five. Tell them, my door is opening. 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 You might not know what it is, but it's being opened. 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 In the name of Jesus. Don't be surprised when you see me next time, when things have changed in my life. My door. Child of God, as per the accuser of brethren, I have 4 minutes to go. It will be a great injustice if I don't ask of the door of salvation. You might be in this way. Remember, divine elevation, you must be connected to Jehovah. You might be in this place and you have never given your life to Jesus. In the next 60 seconds, just rush to the altar. Come to the altar. There's a door of salvation. Because there are some of us, you will get saved. And it will prompt your neighbor. It will prompt your sisters. It will prompt your mother to receive Jesus. Rush to the altar. Rush to the altar. Rush to the altar. Rush, 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 rush. Rush to the altar. Come to the altar. Doors of salvation. Doors of salvation. I call every backslider. Every backslider that is in this house. I want you to come to the altar. Restore your relationship with Jehovah. Restore your relationship with Jehovah. I've got a few seconds. I'm waiting for you. I'm waiting for you right now. I'm waiting for you. You know you are a backslider. Don't be afraid. Come. Come, 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 come. We are not closing our eyes. Come. Come, 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 come. Come. I'm waiting for you. Come. I'm waiting for you. People are coming. The devil is ashamed. Devil, you are too late. You are too late. You thought you could have them, but you are not able. You thought you could take them away, but there's a door of salvation. There's a door of salvation. There's a door of salvation. That is, come, 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 come. People are coming. People are coming. The devil thought you could never make it. But it's too late. He's too late. He thought he could kill you. But it's too late. He thought he could have you. But it's too late. He thought he could put you asunder. But it's too late. He's too late. People are coming. People are coming. People are coming. People are coming. People are coming to Jesus. People are coming to Jesus. Where are you? Come, 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 come. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. I'll ask the service leader just to come and lead them in a prayer of repentance. We still have got a minute to make that prayer. Would you please come and lead them into a prayer of repentance and declare a blessing over the children of God in Jesus' name. Somebody celebrate God for the saints. People that are getting saved in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! We're going to make this prayer now. If you're still coming, there is an opportunity. The door is not closed. The door is open. You can still come. Hallelujah. People that have come to the front, there are people standing behind you. They're going to pray together with you. Believe in this prayer. So if you came to give your life to Christ, lift up your hands. And the people behind you will pray with you and believe God together with you. Would you say this prayer after me? Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I am a sinner. This day, I give my life unto you, Jesus. Forgive my sins. Wash me. Make me your own. Today, I enter through the door of salvation. I receive Jesus to be my Lord and my Savior. From today, I confess with my mouth, Jesus is Lord. From today, I am born again. I am a child of God. I am forgiven. In Jesus' name, I pray and believe. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Everlasting Father, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, these men and women confess you as Lord and Savior of their lives. And we declare over you, Satan, remove your dirty hands out of them. They no longer belong to you. They have transited from hell to heaven. They belong to Jesus. And Jesus, we give you glory. We give you honor. And we give you praise. We receive them in the fellowship of brethren and declare they belong to God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Someone celebrate the King of Kings. Hallelujah. All of you that came to the front, if you turn back, there's someone standing next to you. They will greet you and welcome you to Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you. Welcome to Christ. Hallelujah. Church, you missed a place to celebrate. The Bible says, when one sinner gets born again, angels in heaven rejoice. These ones are more than 10. You can rejoice better than that. Hey! Hallelujah! The devil is a loser. The devil is a loser. We must depopulate hell and populate heaven. You are children of God. Now what you're going to do, you're going to follow that young man with the red sash. We got this direction. If you left your bag, if you left your Bible, pick it. If you didn't leave it, just go this side. God bless you. Walk this side. If you're picking your things, pick them. Someone is waiting for you here. There's someone waiting for you here. Just pick your things. Pick your things. Come back. This brother will wait here until you come. Thank you. Church, blessed be the name of the Lord. Has the door been opened to you? Is someone walking through an open door? There is a door of opportunity. Someone say amen. Did you walk through that opportunity door? The door of utterance. The door of hope. Wewe kama yako bado imefunga jamani, usikae hapo. Tembea kwa ile imefunguka. Sema amen. Hallelujah. Have you been blessed? Can we give all the glory to God? Hallelujah.